Hey guys, it's Sean. Thanks for checking out my channel, and got another video for you. This one is on the Fabrique Nationale Herstal 9mm Striker Fire Pistol, the compact version, FNS9C. Alright, it is this one. Ta-da! The very first video I did on my channel was on the full size, the FNS9. It was the first pistol, well, the first full-size pistol I bought. I've had my carry gun is one I've had back right when I first got out of the Navy, a long time. I've had it for almost 20 years. Is the Bursa Thunder 380, and I do like a sweet little gun. But this is the first. This is the full size. Okay, and finally did get the compact. So I replaced, updated my carry weapon. Wanted it to be a 9mm instead of a 380. Not that, you know, I have any issues with the 380, but I really do like this. Most of my purchases, as you've seen on my channel, have been more rifles, my AR pistol I've made, my 300 Blackout. I do have my 308 bolt gun. I'm going to do a video on my lever gun, which was left to me from my grandparents, a 32 Winchester Special. So, you know, I've got the, who doesn't have a Ruger 10/22. So, you know, I have some other long guns, and that's primarily what my channel has shown as far as the weapons go. I've done a couple of accessory things, but I really wanted to update my carry gun, and after owning my FNS9, the full size, it was a no-brainer that there was no other option for me. It was going to be the compact. One, I really do love my full size. The compact is just a slightly watered down version of it, and it's not watered down on features, just watered down in size. Now, to give you an idea what you get, just straight out the box, okay? The same style box as the full size, okay? Blue interior. FN on that back outside. It is hard plastic, and it is has a lockable. It is a lockable case. You get the manual. You get the lock. You get the warranty. You know, everything that you know that you would normally get with your pistol. You get now the one thing that FN does and has done since I've had my full size. They continue through with the compact. Is you have three magazines with the FN. Of course, the full size are all the 17 round. With the compact, you get three magazines, okay? 1, 2, 3. Two are 12 round magazines. And let me show you the angle on it so you can hopefully see the 12 there. There you go. 12 rounders. One is a flat flush base. One has a pinky extension. And then the third one is a full size. See the 17. I'm trying to keep the glare off of it, sorry. But it is a 17 round full size with the sleeve. And the sleeve slides down on it. I am ordering another, I got another sleeve coming in. They were like $12. At least that was the price for from the my dealer's wholesale guy. Reason being is it is the same as get that out of the way. As the full-size magazine. So they are completely interchangeable from the full-size to the compact, not vice versa, obviously. Just has the sleeve on it. And to show you that I'm not making it up, you know, no sleeve, fits in, you know, bang. You know, doesn't. It won't pull out. Fits the gun perfectly. And again, that's the only difference between them is the sleeve on here. So with the sleeve on, you get a full grip, just like you would on the full size. Now you have essentially the same gun, only a 3.6 inch barrel instead of a 4 inch barrel like you do on the FN9S. So there's your difference right there. That extra, you know, inch or so of real estate is your difference. Now, let me before I even take it apart and show you the difference, the one thing that I've seen people complain about, and not just with the FN, not that I've seen that many compact reviews, I've seen a couple, but with compacts in general, subcompacts and compact guns, they talk about the magazines, the release on the magazine. Now there's your flush mount. You can get a very nice grip on there with the flush magazine. It takes a little while getting used to. That feels kind of funky. But once you put that second hand on there, it doesn't really, there's not, I can't really, that doesn't bother me as much as I thought I would before I first handled the compact at all. Now, that being said, when you're gripping it, here, the fatty part of my hand is in the way. Your fingers are in the way. It's not going to free drop. You're going to have to, I mean, if you could rotate it and get everything off of it, yes, it'll drop right out, no problem. But your normal grip, if you're just trying to, you're going to have to reach and pull it out to reload. That, sorry, tough. If that bothers you so much, carry a full size. Get a shoulder holster to hide it. Or don't really give a shit that you let it print. But no matter, that was the flush. This is the pinky extension. You know, if you rotate, again, it's still, you just got to reach up and pull it. It won't free drop. Now, you could probably maybe get used to doing it from the opposite side and get the free drop because, ta-da, another feature, full ambidextrous pistol. Right side, both slide release safety. Left side, slide release safety. It is a fully ambidextrous pistol straight out of the box. Not, you don't have to pick one, and you can convert it over if you're a southpaw, come take it out and switch it over to the other side like some of the competitors. It's already ambidextrous straight out of the box. So if you do get injured and you have to transition to your weak hand, you already have the ambidextrous safety. That's a big thing for me as far as, I don't know why you wouldn't already have it that way. It's easily done. FN's done it. Other companies have done it. So it's not like it's technologically that difficult to do. Now, that is one difference between the full size and the compact is the size of the safety. The mag release, I'm sorry. Let me get my fingers out of the way. It's a slight difference in the size of the safe, of the slide release, and then where it's, how much it protrudes. It's more flush on the compact. If you can see here, it sticks out a little more on the full size than on the compact. The compact is a bit more flush in line. That was done on purpose. Again, this is obviously more of a carry gun, a concealed carry gun at that. The flushness is less likely to snag on anything is what all my research has shown is what their rationale was for doing it. Now, again, the full size, and here, let me keep it almost parallel. And if I put the magazine in, sorry. I mean, I've almost got it perfectly parallel to the ground. And even there, it still almost fully ejects on its own, right? So that's the one thing I really like about the full size. It is sick. You know, you pick the angle, it's very easy to eject. And then the flared mag works well. It just, I mean, I'm not giving it the slam and hitting it, guys. Competition shooters, that, you know, if you're having to transition and change magazines, the FN would be a great gun for that purpose. But that's the one knock on the compact. And that, again, not just FN, but all compacts is the mag drop. So, now, spec-wise, again, this is a 3.6-inch barrel. The full size is a 4-inch barrel. The overall length on the compact is 6.7 inches. The height is 5.2 inches, and that's measured, like, sitting on a flat surface to the highest point. It's 5.2 inches. The width is 1.35 inches, which is the same as the full size. That part, they're the same. The trigger pull is 5.5 to 7.7 pounds is what they list for both the compact and the full size. I can tell you the one thing I do like about the compact is straight out of the box, the trigger is really, really, really good right out of the box. You know, real break-in period. My full size, you know, I had to take it to the range to get a couple 300 rounds through it, and then it was, you know, butter. It pulls 5.25 on my scale, my full size. My compact, straight out of the box. I've done some dry firing here in the house with the little laser sight thing, but straight out of the box, never been fired. It's pulling 5.5. Okay. Now, the reset is awesome as well, but let's, your normal, like with any striker fire, a little bit of take up, but now, awesome. Awesome. And then let's do the reset. Oop, get rid of the magazine. Sorry about that. And audible. And obviously you can tactile. And then bang again. Extremely nice, smooth trigger. If you're a trigger snob, you'll say it has a tiny bit of creep in it. But for the rest of us, no creep, really. Normal amount of take up, as if almost any striker fire that I've handled. It's been a long time since I've handled the Walther PPQ. I have checked it out, and that, I think, pretty much arguably is the best trigger as among striker fire pistols go. I think that one's the gold standard that everyone tries to reach, you know, as far as straight out of the box from the factory. Now, is as good as trigger as that is? No, I don't believe so. Again, it's been a real long time since I had the Walther in my hand, but I don't believe it's better than the Walther. But I wouldn't want to have to stake my life on the difference, right? It's a really, really good trigger. I think you'll really like the Compax trigger. The takedown is just like the full size. Lock the slide to the rear. Rotate your takedown lever down, release your slide. Now, a lot of people don't like this. Again, there's a few models that, you know, of manufacturers that have it to where you don't have to release a striker. This one you do. Now, as you see, once you rotate that takedown lever and release it, it's slightly out of battery right now. You have to get it, pull it, slide back to where it is in battery, where it's smooth. Then release the striker, then you can just slide it right off. Okay. Now, there's the main difference between the two, is the recoil spring is a captured recoil spring, you know, double spring within a spring. It is a metal guide rod, just like on the full size, where again blocks are plastic. But it is one of those spring within a spring type setups. Okay, then simply lift the barrel out, and you're back to just about any striker fire. It looks very similar on the inside. The barrel is 3.6 inches. The full size, it is 4 inches. It is of the exact same design. It's Cold Hammer Forge, which FN's really known for their barrels. As you can see, polished feed ramp, comes polished from the factory. I didn't do this. Again, and I'm not knocking Glock, guys, I'm really not, but Glock, now I haven't seen the latest version of like the 19 or the 17, but back when I bought my full size, the guide rod was polymer. This one's metal. The feed ramps were not polished on the Glock, they're polished on the FN. 3 magazines instead of 2, and it was cheaper with the night sights. It's just, for me, it's a superior gun, and I'm not making it up or knocking, I'm just saying it is. Now, the other thing that's really great about too is look how beefy your slide surfaces are. They're huge in comparison to most any other gun that I've looked at. These are also user serviceable, like the full size. You can take these out, not have to take it to a gunsmith. But again, as beefy as these are, if you wore those out to where you had to replace these, you've done a whole lot of shooting. I mean, that's a lot, you know, very beefy. The slide, like its full-size counterpart, is stainless steel. Even, you know, the black, you know, doesn't look stainless, but this is stainless steel with the, you know, similar like a nitride type finish, Tenefer type finish, I think is what the Glock, I don't know if that's proprietary to Glock, but that same type of finish. It is stainless steel, okay? Similar on the inside to, you know, what you've come to know. As you can see, it's, you know, very clean as far as the manufacturing goes, and you expect that with FN. They're just, you know, quality company. There's so many good companies out there, and I hate really even talking about so much about Glock or SIG or, you know, better than that one or better than this one. And everyone's kind of a fan, you know, becomes a fan of the one that they like the best, obviously. But they're all good guns. Whichever one that really works for you, I think you'll be more than happy with it. But again, I'm telling you, if it's just how it feels in your hand, you go grab an FN, take a look at it in your gun shop, dry fire a couple times, and I think you'll be hooked. I'm taking the slide off the full size one to show the difference between them, because width, they are identical. The striker mechanism is identical. And see if I can keep that lined up. Okay, so from the barrel back, you're talking identical. The width is identical. The sights are identical. The overall length is a little bit shorter for the compact, obviously. You know, 3.6-inch barrel vice a 4-inch barrel. And then the recoil spring is the main difference between the two. Now, both of these are the Trigicon Tritium night sights from FN. Not an aftermarket, and I didn't put them in myself. These were from the factory. These are the three-dot sights, okay? Now, let me get it on my shirt right there. There's a little bit of a contrast, okay? There's that one. Line this one up. And there's that one. Now, we'll get you a little bit closer view, because the one thing, and it's, I tried cleaning up. I thought maybe it was just due because I've owned, you know, the full-size one for, you know, a couple years, and maybe just because it was brand new. For me, it just seems like the sight, the dot, on the compact is just a tad bit more, stands out more, you know, daytime, the normal look at it. I don't know. I don't know if it'll translate in the video, but it just seems like the front dot, my shirt being a blue shirt, I'm trying to hold, you know, give you a little bit of a color contrast there for the sight. Just seems like the dot stands out just a hair better on the compact, you know, front sight post than the full size. And again, this one is the compact, and this one is the full size. So now they're both Tritium from Trigicon, front and rear. So total darkness, you know, again, it's a radioactive isotope. It glows because of that energy. You don't have to hold it up to the light, get the phosphorus going, and then have a night sight. You can leave this in the safe 24/7, total darkness, open it up, pitch black house, you got three dots. They stand out very well, that lime green, neon green type, greenish yellowish look that you think for night sights. That's what these are. Awesome. And again, the price I paid, this is March of 2017. I bought it literally last week, not 4 or 5 days ago, so just at the end of February, and I paid $500. This is in Akron, Ohio area. The guy that taught the CCW class, he has his own dealer, FFL dealer. I bought it from him. It's $500 with the night sights. And that is the same price that I paid 2 years ago for my full-size FN from the gun store downtown. The guy that I bought my AR from, my bolt gun, I bought it from him. I got my first FN, the full-size pistol, from him, and he gave me the price he gave me. Now, he gave me a little bit of prices. I've done deals with him before, but it still was $500 with the night sights. The Glock 19, to give a perspective, at that time, 2 years ago, was going to be $525, $530 without the night sights. So these are very, very affordable guns, guys. Don't think, my first impression, you know, before I was looking, I thought from a price perspective that the FN was, you know, like a little more than a SIG and a little less than a HK. That proves not to be the case. They're extremely affordable guns. They're super, super quality. And again, you wouldn't go wrong with the FN, with the SIG, with the Glock, with the Smith & Wesson M&P Shield series. None of those would you ever go wrong with. So price features. If you hold it in your hand and you are and you are a fan of the Browning, you know, 1911 and grip angle style pistols, you will just absolutely fall in love with the FN, either the compact or the full size. Now, I haven't held the long slide version, but I would imagine it is identical too. Now, the stippling is one thing from the reviews that I've seen and comments that I've read that is an issue for some people from the full size, and they both share the same type of stippling on the grips. Okay, so you can see it's the same stippling all the way around. They both have textured on the front of the trigger guard, stippling on front, back, and sides. Now, it is an aggressive stippling, there's no denying that, but it's not a painful grip. It's not a painful stippling, no way. You grip it, you can feel that's there. You can tell that you have something with some texture to it, but it is not at all uncomfortable, okay? So, and it's on purpose that way, guys. I mean, it's designed if you were sweaty or, God forbid, bloody, you know, just to keep the gun from slipping out of your hand. So, it's not going to be a powder puff contest. It's a gun. So, and once you grab it, you'll see what I'm talking about. You know, please just do yourself a favor and go to your gun shop and grab a hold of one. You'll see what I'm talking about. So, it is an aggressive texturing as far as, in comparison to many others. But again, not uncomfortably so. It is just more aggressive. Magazine capacity, I already said, was 12 rounds, one in a chamber, so 13 rounds, and it comes with three mags, two 12 rounds and one 17 round magazine. Now, the other difference between its full size big brother is the back strap. While both of them come with two back straps, comes with the flat, which is my preferred, and then it comes with one that is more upside down. I'm sorry, it would go on like this, which has more of a hump to it. Okay. A little bit more of a swell in the back. The difference between how you remove them is what they've modified a touch, and I think for the better. This is in the back. There's just a simple roll pin right there. Just take a punch and push it straight out. It's not in there hard at all. The full size, the way they did the back strap, but you had to take like a paper clip or a punch. You pushed in here and then slid it off. That released it from the internals and slid it off. It's a little bit shaky on this one, but again, it's not like you change that all the time. You try one, you try the other, see which one fits your hand the best, then you're going to leave it there. So it's not like you got to do it every time. However, I do agree with the change on the compact with just, the little push your roll pin out, swap it out, put the other one in, push the pin back in. Excellent. Now, they both do have standard pick rail on the bottom. The compact has a 1, 2, 3 slot rail, where the full size one gives you 4. Okay, but 3 slots, plenty of real estate there to put laser or light or laser light combo, a stream light, whatever your pick your poison for that. If you're a light guy, if you want to do that on the light. The night sights, again, the Tritium from Trigicon night sights are completely awesome. I mean, these things glow great. If you go to the gun shop, ask the guy if you can take it in the back or if he can take you in the back into a storeroom or something and show you how, pitch black, and you'll see how awesome these sights are. The life expectancy from everything I've researched is like 14 years for the night sights. So you will really like them. So guys, the awesome carry gun, FNS 9mm, the compact version, striker fired handgun, and the full size is great as well. So great capacity. It's not a little 7-shotter. You get a tons more, and it's not that big, not that much larger of a form factor. I carried a compact all day today. I have a Alien Gear inside the waistband holster that I use. Pop that in, very, very concealable. It's a very comfortable holster as well. If you haven't tried the Alien Gears, do yourself a favor. give those guys a try. It's not expensive at all, especially there's tons of holsters out there that are over $100 or right at 100. For like $40-$50, you can do the combo deal with them as well. But they give you a lifetime, you know, swap out for your, like, if I were to sell my FN and I went to a Glock or a Smith or whatever, I can take the shell off, send it back. They'll send me a shell for my new pistol. So if I get the HK or, you know, I can send them my old one. They'll send me a new one free of charge. They're a great company to deal with. And I'm not knocking the others. If you've got another one that's great for you, go for it. But, again, cost is very affordable. It's a good quality holster. It's comfortable to wear. So check those guys out and check some reviews on it. You know, it's not just me. Now, back to reviews, because I've kind of used Glock, and a lot of people use Glock as kind of the good comparison. It's like Aimpoint with a red dot. It's a good thing to compare it to. They're very popular, super, you know, tons of them being manufactured, tons of accessories. If you can't find an accessory for a Glock, then that's an awful damn hard accessory for any other gun, no doubt about it. Now, my argument back to the FN over the Glock. Like this one that I have, it already has three magazines. You got three mags. It already has night sights, has a pick rail that's a, you know, universal pick rail, striker fired. All I need is a holster. Alien Gear makes holsters for the FN series pistols, so I didn't have to wait. It wasn't a special make. So, kind of argument solved, right? Now, if you want to really trick out your gun, that's your gig. The FN might not be for you, just sort of because those accessories would be hard to come by. Not like a Glock or Smith & Wesson or a SIG. More people to touch this, the more popular it get, the more people will make accessories for it. Because I know of no one that's grabbed this that didn't go, wow, this is really, really a nice gun. And again, don't take my word for it. Hickok 45, a bona fide, self-admitted Glock guy. When he did his review on the FNS9, and he did full-size and a compact, he did a review on both, but he stated on there that it was surprised him how much he liked this gun. It's super surprising, and like I said, he's a bona fide, self-admitted Glock fanboy. He said it would be hard for him not to purchase this over a Glock if you had to purchase more than just one. So check his video out, and you'll see what I'm talking about. Such did a review on this and absolutely loved it, sung high praises of it. Mr. Guns and Gear, same thing. Larry Vickers just did a video, a review on the FNS9. I don't know if it was the compact or full size, escapes me at the moment. You know, like I say, guys, it ain't just me. If you grab one of these, you will be impressed. I guarantee you. It is an incredible gun. Again, as always, please leave your comments in the bottom. Any questions, please like and subscribe. I do appreciate you stopping by my channel. Take some friends out with you and go shoot a lot. You know, support the Second Amendment. Hopefully some of those friends are not gun people and we convert them. They'll just have a ball. Thanks for watching. Again, FNS9 compact in 9mm, obviously. They do make it in a 40, if you're a 40 guy. And the paint job I did. This doesn't come with the blue paint. I did that on my one of my ARs. I did the paint job thing, and I really liked the way it looks, so I'm kind of a little bit decorating some of the others. So it will not come with this with the paint job. That was me. And if you want to do that, you want to try it, it's super easy. Tons of videos out there for you to do it. The best thing I've found to do is literally, honest to God, believe it or not, nail polish. Not any kind of special paint. Just go get some decent quality nail polish and the non-acetone, let me stress, non-acetone nail polish remover. Paint it on, let it dry, take it like a cotton ball, dip it in the nail polish remover, then lightly go over it. It won't dig down into the recess from the stamping, so it takes everything off the surface, leaves behind what's in the recess from the stamping. And I think it looks really cool. And you can do a bunch of different colors and everything. But that is, I've accessorized on my gun, both of my pistols. I did the paint job thing. Again, I think it looks pretty cool. But it doesn't come like that from FN. And I chose the blue that matches the blue and inside of the box. So that's why. And I'm a blue freak anyway, but you know, as far as colors go. Turn this around. So, anyway, the FNS9 compact, awesome carry gun. Very, you know, folks, if you're looking for a smaller frame gun to be your daily carrier, doesn't print as much. I mean, theirs are some slender. You know, Glock's makes a couple models that are super slender. For me, I want this one is a better option. I prefer the extra rounds. Instead of 7 or 8 plus one, I have 12 plus one. I prefer those extra rounds if it comes down to it. So, guys, thanks for watching my channel. Please leave your comments down below. If you have any questions, again, please leave them down below as well. I'll do my best to get back to you as quick as I can with them. Thanks for watching. Go shoot. Go have a good time. And have a great day. Thanks.